from you on how introverts can make excellent leaders. Carson is a voracious reader, bubbly, kind-hearted, and funny. In her free time, she enjoys volunteering at the local animal shelter and spending quality time with her friends and family. Please put your hands together for Carson.
However, are they the most effective leaders? In society, there's a very real bias against introverted people. Schools and workplaces encourage and count on cultures of gregariousness, with many conventional classrooms catering to the fallacy of group work, even in unexpected subjects such as math or art, where you may initially think that those classes require one's individual train of thought, with group work taking away their individuality. Or workplaces, also using the technique of group work, and even open plan offices where there are no walls or solitude for employees to do their work in private. Society would prefer the man of action over contemplation, the one who would say, let's just do it, to, be this the right or best way? Historians have called the 20th century the century of personality, which makes sense. The self-help books coming out with titles like How to Win Friends and Influence People, or The Charismatic Edge, The Art of Captivating and Compelling Communication. When in the past, these types of books have had titles such as Character, The Grandest Thing in the World. In addition, being introverted is different than being shy. Being shy is the fear of social judgment. Introversion is how you respond to stimulation. Someone who is introverted may avoid large groups or feel most energized when alone and have time to compose and innovate in solitude with their thoughts. With all this said, I would like to say introverts can make the greatest, most powerful leaders. A study done by Adam Grant from Wharton Management Program challenged the consensus that extroverts make the best leaders. The study was done on pizza delivery franchise productivity and team effectiveness. It showed that introverts often deliver better results when working with productive employees, those who may voice their thoughts and ideas, unlike their extroverted counterparts who may have tunnel vision to their outlook on things. Those leaders are less likely to enhance their productive employees and or feel threatened with their position of power. I would like to say why introverts make the best leaders in 5 points. The first being that they are more sagacious. Introverts take a circumspect approach at the possible idea of risk. They are predisposed to be more thoughtful during the decision-making process. This isn't to say that introverts don't take risks. However, they are more prudent in capital and resources. My next point, being that introverts are listening learners. Introverts listen intently while others are speaking and internalize it before they speak. They listen while others are talking instead of thinking what they should say next. They listen and learn. According to Susan Cain, founder of the Quiet Revolution and author of Quiet, The Power of Introverts in a World That Can't Stop Talking, introverts are intrinsically motivated. Therefore, they quest for stimulation regardless of external reward. The third point is that introverts manage ambiguity well. As mentioned, they're intrinsically motivated, so it is easier for them to work with minimal information and resist self-defeating impulsions. A common trait of introverts is persistence and is why they stay with uncertainty longer. Even Albert Einstein, well-known introverted leader, said, "It's not that I'm so smart, it's that I stay with problems longer." And that is how introverts find certainty out of uncertainty, through persistence. Next, introverts possess the quality of humility. This is not to say that extroverted people are not humble. Part of being introverted is not always wanting to be in the spotlight. In a 2006 survey, leadership study done by James T. Waddell from Regent University said, the introverts want to maximize potential of their workers and therefore shine the limelight on them. As a servant leader, someone who enjoys serving others to maximize the potential of their employees, introverted leaders are able to focus their full attention on strengthening the foundation of any business, organization, or project. Also, a possible explanation for introverts' humility is that they have an acute sense of their abilities and limitations. So, they also have the ability to recognize mistakes and weaknesses, which are imperative qualities to making an excellent leader. Finally, and probably most importantly, introverts are able to and in fact enjoy working alone. Solitude is an indispensable fact of creation and innovation. For instance, some of the world's major religious leaders, such as Jesus, Moses, Buddha, and Muhammad, all went on periods of solitude and had epiphanies and revelations. Most of society's norms wouldn't have even been possible if it weren't for introverts innovating alone. Steve Wozniak, co-founder of Apple, along with Steve Jobs, invented the first Apple computer while working alone in his cubicle of Hewlett-Packard, who had been working at the time. Other introverted leaders you may know are Mark Zuckerberg, founder of Facebook, Bill Gates, Gandhi, Abraham Lincoln, the amazing Theodore Geisel, better known as Dr. Seuss, in addition, Larry Page, CEO and co-founder of Google, and Rosa Parks. These people, all being prominent pioneers in the world, were introverted. A third to half of the population is covered in introverts who need solitude. It has been said that influence is important, but aloneness is freedom. And working alone affords more opportunities to focus on pushing the envelopes. And because introverts know how to work independently, they are able to make amazing leaders when given the opportunity. And now, I'm going to leave you with two calls to action. The first being, to stop pushing the abundance of group work that is currently. This is not only for introverts, but for extroverts to learn to work alone. Because beware of those who constantly seek a group, they are nothing alone. You're nothing alone. Next and last, give introverts the opportunity to be leaders. They have proven the best results in productivity and effectiveness, and some of the world's most powerful and impactful leaders have been introverts. Give leaders the chance to be introverts, and they will prove to be the best. Thank you.